Bitsets in C++ are a powerful and convenient tool which will often speed up your program around 30 times. This first problem doesn't require bitsets, but in a moment we will move to a harder version. Let's say you hire n workers. For each of them you know their schedule for a month. For example, they are available on 2nd, 5th and 6th day of a month. You need to find two workers, let's say, to assign some project to them, and their intersection of schedule should be as big as possible. Days when they are both at work. For example, if this is schedule of the first worker, he is available on 2nd, 3rd, 5th, 6th and 8th day, then 2nd and 3rd worker. For each pair we can compute their intersection. For those two, they will be both at work on days 2, 5 and 8, so their intersection is 3. For those two I see only the 2nd day, so intersection is 1. For those two, this is already computed. For those two, the intersection will be just a 2 again, so 1 day. This is the best intersection, so the answer is 3. If you iterate over all the pairs of workers, you will have n square times the time needed to find an intersection. We are talking about a month, so at most 30 days. And you can merge such two lists. You can find the intersection, for example, using two pointers method. It will be then linear in total. 30, let's say that this is in general D, the number of days. And this complexity is slightly too slow. If you watched the first lecture, you should already know that a subset of some set of numbers from 1 to 30 can be represented as a binary number of length 30. This schedule with 2, 3, 5, so on, I can represent as a binary number 0, 1, 1, and so on, where 0 means I'm not available on the first day of a month, then 2nd, yes, 3rd, yes, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, and then a lot of zeros, till the 30th day. Similarly, this will be 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, and so on. And this will be 1, 1 for 1st and 2nd day, a lot of zeros, then eventually 1 for 10, 0, 1, and so on. Intersection of two workers is now just bitwise AND between two numbers and can be computed in constant time. This way we get rid of D. The complexity will be n squared. The whole solution is first change every set into a binary number, store it as a single int, iterate over all the pairs of workers, for each of them compute bitwise AND, and in their bitwise AND we need the number of ones, the number of common days. How to get that number? The number of ones in binary representation of a number is called popcount, and in C++ there is a function for that. It's called underscore underscore built-in underscore popcount of a number. Remember, if number x is a long-long or unsigned long-long, you need ll. It will be built-in popcount ll of x. The solution then becomes for every schedule A of one worker, for every B of some other worker, you need to consider this built-in blah 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 popcount of A and bitwise and B. And this operation works in constant time. But what will happen if I change a month into a year in the problem statement? This time the number of days in the year, D, is let's say up to 365. Single int is not enough to store that many bits. It will be a bit inconvenient, but we can make a separate bit mask for every month, because 30 bits will fit in single int, and then we'll have 12 such numbers. We can compute bitwise AND for each month and sum up those pop counts. We can do the same for unsigned long-longs, and in general the code will look like this. Let maxd be the number of days, then the number of unsigned long-longs I need, each with 64 bits, is maxd divided by 64 plus 1, so to round it up. And I create a big array, two-dimensional array, for each of n workers, I want k unsigned long-longs. This way for each worker I remember all maxd bits. And intersection of two workers is computed by iterating over all values from 0 to k minus 1, for each of them adding the built-in popcount ll of bitwise AND. The complexity this time is n square, the number of pairs of workers, times the intersection, d divided by 64, or 32 if you use unsigned ints. This value is around 6, so for the constraints given in the problem it should be okay. But the code is very inconvenient. It will be unpleasant in harder problems, and bitwise shifts will be a huge pain. Fortunately, the code you're seeing right now on the screen can be handled by bitsets, and then it becomes just this. bit set of some length, max D, is a binary number with that many bits, and it already handles bitwise operations and shifts. You don't need to split into groups of 32 or 64 bits, you don't need to iterate over anything, bitsets have you covered. The complexity is the same, d divided by 64 for an intersection. More often it is written in fact as divided by 32, but what we should really write as complexity is d divided by w, word size on machine you are working on. It is nowadays often 64, but when we talk about complexity, we're not talking about running something on a particular machine. If we ever get more powerful machines that is able to compute something in constant time for two very big numbers, then this means W is bigger. Though in editorials of problems in competitive programming, you will usually just see D divided by 32. Let's learn more about bitsets. This is how you create one. This will be a bitset of size 365. In general, this must be a constant. You cannot read n and they say you create bitset of size n. Compiler must know this size, so it would split it into those chunks of some number of bits. Under the hood, bitset is just an array of, for example, unsigned long longs, and this is why compiler needs to know what is that array size. Instead of built-in popcount, you have a.count, like you saw already on the previous slide. You also can do A and B, A, OR, XOR, and so on, all the bitwise operations. And you can do A shifted by something or shifted to the other side by, for example, I don't know, 5. This will give you bitset shifted by 5, just like a binary number. Usually you should think about bitset as longer binary mask or set that is able to give you quick intersection, number of elements, and a shift. Let's solve some problems. First, different numbers. You're given up to 10 million numbers. Each is between 0 and billion, all are integers. How many different values are there? We could put everything into a set and just then print set.size, but it will be too slow. It is n log n, and let's say time limit is tight enough that it will not pass. Unordered set is also quite slow, even though it's O of n expected. But let's try to find something faster. Take a moment now to solve this easy problem with bitsets. It's almost okay to say that we should create a Boolean array, say visited, of size 1 billion, 10 to 9 plus 1. The thing is, a single Boolean value, it takes the whole byte, and such an array, it will take 1 billion bytes, so around 1 gigabyte. This is usually too much. Fortunately for us, creating a bitset of the same size, it will consume that many bits, so it will be 8 times more efficient. A single bool will take a bit instead of a byte. You create bitset of size 1 billion, it will take 128 megabytes, 8 times more efficient. And what we do with those numbers from the input, we say, if not visited of x, then increase the answer by 1 and say that visit of x becomes true. The complexity is linear plus the time to create this bitset, but it is very fast. Take a quick look at these two codes. Both of them have complexity O of maximum value, let's say uppercase V, it is 1 billion, divided by 32. This is complexity to create those arrays. Also, this is space complexity, and it's good enough, plus n to read values and do something. And remember, in this second method here, visit.count, this complexity is O of size of bitset, here 1 billion, divided by 32. And it's good to note that this has very low constant factor. Operations with bitsets and generally bitwise operations are very fast. Let's of course remember that this will not work in general case when numbers are from 0 to 10 to 18. Then you cannot create that big bitset. Here are two more problems. I will explain the statement and then give you a moment to think about them. Knapsack or subset sum is about a set of numbers, say 2, 4, 7, 8, and some goal sum of values, 14. We need to take some subset of numbers on the left without taking the same number twice, so we cannot take 7 and 7. So their sum of them would be 14. Here it is possible because it's 8 plus 4 plus 2, so we print yes. There is a subset with the total sum exactly 14. Triangles in a graph. We are given a graph with n up to 2000 vertices. The number of edges is not limited, so maybe there are edges between all pairs of vertices. We need to count triangles of so triples of vertices A, B, C, such that all three vertices are connected. In this graph, if I'm not mistaken, there are two triangles. One is those three vertices, there are edges between them, and the other is those three vertices. Again, there are edges between every pair of them. The brute force will obviously be n cubic here, where we iterate over all the triples and check if they are connected, and this is too slow. You need to speed this up. You can pause the video and think about solutions to both problems, then get back to watching. In knapsack, there is quite standard n times w dynamic programming approach. We create a Boolean array with values true and false, only the first one is true first, false, 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 and so on. The size of this array is w plus 1, and the ith cell, let's say it's called ken of I, means if we can get a subset with the sum equal to I. At the beginning, only for 0 we have true, because we can make an empty subset with sum equal to 0. Now, if there is some value, let's say 2, what we will do is we will say, if there is a subset so far with sum I, then now there is I plus 2. So if first value is 2, then because there is true here, we will also mark this one as true. Let's say the second value is 3. Then because there is true here, we will make a true there. And so the same here. So true and true and so on. At the end, for every value from 0 to w, we will know if there is subset with exactly this sum. You can analyze the code on the right. It's crucial to think about this array ken as a binary mask. It will be a number consisting of zeros and ones. And adding a value, it means that if there is one somewhere, then we also want to say now there is one three positions to the right, if the new value is one. So this is equivalent to taking the number, shifting it to the right by three, and computing bitwise OR of two numbers. Bitwise OR of those two will be 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. We count those unnecessary bits because those will represent values w plus 1 and w plus 2. We are not interested in that. And this is a new state of array ken. This is new code using bitsets. It's only shorter, simpler, and it is faster, because this time, instead of having n times w for each of n elements, we do some bitwise operations in complexity uppercase w divided by 32. With bitsets, we can still say ken of something is true or 1, just like we would do with a Boolean array. But here, this after noticing that it is bitwise shift and computing OR, we can do something simpler. Please note that we can even do this to just save some implementation time, and maybe even running time, because this operation for computer is a bit simpler than this one. It's better to say A plus equal B instead of A is equal A plus B. Triangles in a graph is a bit easier, because we can directly say that there are some subsets, so we can represent them as bitsets. A adjacency list for every vertex is a set of other vertices. If vertex 1 is connected with 2, 4, 5, I can say that this will be bitset 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, where this means edge to 2, edge to 4, edge to 5. There is no edge from vertex to itself. For 2, it will be 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, and so on. This is for now just an alternative representation of the input. Instead of list of edges or adjacency list for every vertex, I can remember bit mask of adjacency for every vertex. And thanks to that, I can now take two vertices and compute, well, what can I do? In particular, I can compute the intersection. The intersection of neighbors of 1 and 2, so this mask, bitwise and this mask, it will find just one common bit on position 4. It will mean that 1 and 2 are both connected to 4. 1 and 2 are both connected to 4. This doesn't mean that there is a triangle, because we need one more edge between 1 and 2. So the algorithm should be, for every pair of vertices, u and v, if u and v are connected with a direct edge, then compute their bitwise end of adjacency and add their pop count to the answer. One last detail is, at the end, you should say that you print answer divided by 3, because every triangle you will compute 3 times. If there is triangle ABC, for a pair AB you will detect that there is C in common neighborhood, common adjacency list, then for AC and for BC. Like in our example, for pair 1, 2, you detected that there are edges to 4, and also there is edge between 1 and 2. But also for a pair 1, 4, you detected that there is common bit 2 here and there, and there is edge between 1 and 4. So you add to the answer plus 1, and so on and so on. So every triangle is computed 3 times. In the video description, you will find a link to my CodeForces article about the same topic, where you will find more problems and bonuses if you want to practice bitsets more. I hope you enjoyed this lecture. Consider subscribing and turning on notifications on this channel not to miss future videos. Bye!